Have you ever faced an automated test that sometimes it passes and sometimes it fails? We call them flaky tests. You're gonna see that in practice, although this seems very strange, flaky tests happen very often. And what we see is that as soon as we have one of them, the software development team starts to lose confidence in the test suite because the team never knows if the test is failing for a good reason, meaning the test is actually pointing to an existing bug, or if it is failing because it just has this crazy behavior. And flaky tests can happen for many different reasons. For example, you have a test that depends on an external infrastructure like a database or a web service. And when the database is running and the web service is available, the test passes. But as soon as the database is off, the test fails. So the test keeps passing and failing according to the availability of the external infrastructure. Or a flaky test can happen because developers are sharing resources. For example, your development team shares the database used by the tests, and then at some point, some other person changes the database, and this affects your tests. Or because you have timeouts. This is very common in web applications, actually. Your test is waiting for something to happen in the web application, and the web application, for some reason, gets 1 second slower, and then your test fails because of that. Or because you have interacting tests. So test one, for some reason, interacts with test two and vice versa. One test depends on the other. So these are all plausible causes for flakiness. In the XUnit Test Patterns book, the author provides us with a huge decision table to understand and tackle the cause of a flaky test. For example, does the flaky test get worse over time? Getting worse in terms of speed, the test gets slower and slower and slower. If that is true, this means that you probably have a resource leakage that makes the test to become slower over time. And if this is not true, you probably have a non-deterministic test. Does it happen when the test is executed alone? If so, then you probably have a lonely test, which is a test that only works when executed alone, probably because it depends on some state that is created by previous tests. If not, then you probably have tests that are interacting with each other. I'm not going to discuss the entire decision table here, but you can see it in the book or at the author's website. So there are so many reasons for tests to be flaky. And one interesting finding from research is that there's a correlation between a test being affected by the smells we discussed in the previous videos and flakiness. And that if you actually refactor the test smell out of the class, odds are that you're also fixing the flakiness problem. Test code quality indeed matters.